So we'll start with solving problems about diarrhea. Diarrhea, you know what diarrhea is? Yeah, there are two meanings. Like in Russian, when you say the word "plushit," it can be "plushit Ленин." Плушит Ленина равна длине Ленина умножить на его ширину. Да? И есть площадь, как площадь геометрической фигуры. So, same in English. Area as magnitude of area of some region in the plane, or area as a space. So we will solve problems about areas. And my first question to recall what you know is, if you have a square, you know what a square. This is a square. Sides are equal, angles are right angles. So the area of a square of the side A is equal to
A square.
Just also a square. A times a. Why is it equal to a times a? Who knows? How to prove that the area of the square is a times a? Is a square. So first of all, we must start with some measure unit area with which we measure. So the unit area is the square of side x1. So, and we, by definition, we take this area to be equal to one, whatever. If it is 1 centimeter, then it will be 1 centimeter square. Then if I have a square whose side is an integer number of centimeters, like this, each one is one. So the total area is the sum of these ones. Okay? So how many squares will it be? If there are 4 squares here and 4 here, then the total will be 16. So this will be just 4 squares. Okay? If the side is not integer number of, so I want to take and a little more. Then how do I measure this? These are units. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, to measure the area in this case. How can we find the area of this square whose side is not integer number of centimeters? So, fraction. What do we do in this case? What would you do? So, if you have, for example, I draw a rectangle or square on your paper, and I ask you, find the area, what would you do? Suppose this is 3.5. So, what do we do in this case? Why the area? What would be the area of one rectangle like this?
One?
Yeah. What? One half. Why is the area is one half? Why do you think it is one half? Okay, you can, if you can say it in English, say it in Russian.
Один, потому что одна из его сторон такая единица, а вторая, то есть площадь
меняется произведение. But why the area of a rectangle is a times b? Why? Why do you want it?
Можно
разбить на, значит, b4 квадрат. How? There is only, this is our measure of unity. One times one. Okay? So here we have one and here we have one half. Why do we multiply one by one, one by one half to ever to get the area?
Смотрите, если я
возьму
один квадрат,
составлю
один на один, то вот
we can take our unit square, so we can make do two things. Yes. We can put unit squares together to make a big area. We tie a big area. But also we can divide it into parts that are certainly equal in area, or geometrically equal. Then we can put one part on another part, which is called congruent in English. In Russian sometimes also. So congruent parts. Congruent means that you can take two congruent figures. You can take one figure, another figure can put one on another one. So we take all the same. In Russian we say равная фигура. В русском языке тоже есть слово конгруентное, в свое время его оно было в учебнике Колмогорова. Есть такое слово конгруентное по-русски, но в школе по-русски обычно говорят равные. Okay, so two parts are congruent, and therefore their areas are the same. Okay, and then we get okay, the total is one. They are the same, and there are two of them, so each of them will be one part. So in this way, we can find the area of these small pieces, and how do we find this one? Yes, we can divide this into equal halves and get one of these. Okay. So now maybe you can tell me what do we do if we have a square which is P divided by Q centimeters. These are integer numbers, you know, fraction. And also if B divided by Q.
Когда я умножаю P разбить на Q, умножить на P разбить на Q, это будет P потом разбить на Q.
But why do we have to multiply?
We
don't have, like, imagine, we don't have the formula. Of course, you know the formula. You know this, the area is A times B, okay? You know it, I know. I know that you know, and you know. But now I want you to understand why do we use this formula. Okay, you understand me?
Yes.
So why do you multiply this by this? Here we proved that the area of this square and the side length of 3.5 is this square. Okay. What about if you have some fraction, P over Q? P is, for example, like, 10, 9 tenths. And here also. Same. Why do we multiply? Can you explain? Quick. Understand more basic things. Where do we start with the areas? Because most of the things that we will do will be cut and, at least for some time, cut and replace and rearrange the pieces. We won't use formulas, but this is a good start to understand about cutting and rearranging. So, how can we prove that this area is 81 over if we have a square of size 3/4 times 3/4, how can we prove that this is 9/16? How? Using what we know before. What we knew before. How? Четыре раза что?
Ну вот, я.
Вот такой, и да. Ты четыре такие.
Да.
Четыре. Ну, 16.
Да. This can be done, yeah, but I need maybe a more universal way that will help us. Because every time you will, if you have a fraction, divide this square into smaller squares. What would be the natural way to divide it into smaller squares? Yes. How many? Divided into P
pieces
square pieces. Each side into P pieces, and the entire square into P square pieces. And each piece will be a square with side 1 over Q. And its area will be equal to
1 divided by Q square.
Because why? The unit square will have Q square pieces like this after that. Okay. So now we can take any rectangle whose sides are, for example, here P over Q and here R over Q. It's different now. Then the area will be equal to PR divided by Q square, which is the same if we denote this by A and this by B, it will be what?
R over
A, B. Okay. So we have proved that if a side, if both sides are, how do we call these numbers that are representable as fractions?
Обязаны знать, по-русски они безусловно знают, это проблема в переводе.
Okay, in Russian, how do we call the numbers of the form P over Q? Дроби is a fraction. And also, what is another word? Some numbers can be represented in this form, and some cannot be represented. But this we cannot, because these numbers in English it's called incommensurable. In Russian we say несоизмеримо. We cannot find a length that will divide into this side integer number of times and here integer number of times. That's the problem. So what do we do in this case? Okay, I will tell you because this is not important for us. So in this case we use approximation. For example, square root of 2 is equal to, for example, who knows?
По-русски. Аппроксимация, они не знают даже по-русски.
Approximation. I was. Do you know what is approximation? Нет? Слышали это?
Нет.
А вы ездили на поезде? Вот здесь. На поезде ездили? Да? Слышали, как объявляют следующую станцию?
Да.
Так.
Очень много.
Просим, хорошо. Молодец. Просим, а по-гречески просим, это следующее. И близкий на самом деле, близкий. Ну, ближайшая станция, просим, хорошо, ближайшая станция. Просим. Это означает приближение. Математики говорят approximation. Ну, а по-английски приближение, как говорят approximation.
Приближение.
So we take the approximate value of square root of 2. Who knows what is square root of 2 in decimal? What are the first digits of square root of 2? Do you know?
1.
1.
4.
4. Then?
1.
1. Then?
4.
Yes.
2.
And so, and square root of 3?
1, 7.
Another genius. 1, 7. But to be a genius, you must tell me four numbers, four digits. 1, 7, then? 2. If I remember it correctly. I don't remember what's the next one. Anyway. So what do? We cut this. First of all, we can the first approximation. We cut off the fractional part. And this will be 1. Okay, I believe. Then this is still not the real world. It is smaller, but much better. So I have one more digit and a very thin strip around the border and get next approximation. And so on. So the more digits I take, the closer approximation I get. So this is how we, and for each of these new rectangles, the area is the product. So in the end, it will remain the product of these two numbers. This more or less like this is called. Okay? So this is how we find the formula AB for any two AM. Okay, now let's, so this is finished. Now we have, this is the main formula for us, for everybody in who is measuring areas.
На самом деле, вот эта идея с разбиением единичного квадрата на одинаковые кусочки, она абсолютно правильная, разумеется, да? Но была мысль про то, что складывать из них. На самом деле, это тоже можно было. Вот смотрите, там берешь 7 четвертых, я не знаю, там, да? Действительно, можно приложить их 4 штуки, и будет 7. Понятно, да? То есть можно было вот такие маленькие, малюсенькие, а можно было, наоборот, делать единицы здоровые. Главное, рано или поздно свести все дело к единичному квадрату.